really important when you want to write automated bots that can understand human speech and answer back. Finally, your creativity. So, you don't have to write. So today's going to be very hands-on. I'm not going to sit up here and code and talk to you guys for an hour. Instead, what's going to happen is I'm going to give you boilerplate. Okay, I'm going to go through explaining the boilerplate, understanding each single part of it, and then I want you guys to go wild, meaning take pieces of code, change pieces of code, try to understand, try to make it behave in different ways, and actually try to understand what's going on. And you can also code in your own responses for the bot and stuff like that. Okay, you will learn so much more by trying out, changing different things inside of the code rather than learning from me just writing each line of code and you copying along. Okay, so don't be surprised that there's not a lot of copying going on, copying from the screen, that is. Okay, working groups that ask for help from each other. So at this point, I'm going to introduce mentors. These are just going to be guys who are going to be walking around, and basically they're the people you can ask questions to. Okay, so me. So I'm just going to say that I get an example of. Tony's going to be walking around, helping people. So if you see him standing up and walking around, if he's sitting down on his laptop, that means he's probably working along as well. But if he's standing up and walking around, that means that he can ask the questions. Joel, stand up, please. So Joel's also going to be walking around, helping out. Okay, so again, another person can ask questions too. Sunny, there's another mentor we can ask questions from. Jonathan, back there, the room chair, the original founder of Tailchairs as well. Definitely a good person to ask questions about JavaScript too. I'll be walking around as well, so when you go into the hands-on session, you can help walking around and ask me questions as well. And then finally, Ivan.
Just leave it there.
Before we go to the boilerplate, okay, and I'll walk you guys through that because it's hard to get started with the measurement platform. There's a couple of steps that we need to do before we get started. And finally, for those of you guys who are already like pro coders, first of all, you shouldn't be in this workshop, but since you are, that's okay. My challenge to you is try to handle structured messages. So Facebook doesn't just do text messages like the messenger platform. You can actually accept like location, pictures, and stuff like that. So you can actually experiment with it, like, okay, maybe I want to save a picture, and then after that, return it back to the user and enter as much as you were. So that's my challenge to you guys. All right, cool. So we're gonna go through this basically. So guys, you guys should follow along here, okay? So if you try to edit in here right now, obviously I'm the owner. give you like a little name, a little random name here. You can change the name here by clicking here and then changing it here. Okay, and this is the URL of your project. Now this is important because we're going to use it later. Okay, now to change the name, you change the name, it's always okay. Okay, so once you've remixed,
I want to learn from
what's not
working.
You guys were not Facebook developers. Okay?
It's your OS, man.
You'll see
my app. It's
my OS. So I have stuff there, go look at it.
Just not connected, but it's the internet.
Too many people.
Maybe.
Okay? So
once
you've remixed, the name of the app can be whatever you want. In Facebook, we gotta do two things. In order to start using the messenger platform to actually start using chatbots, we gotta do two things. First of all, we gotta create this app. The second thing we gotta do, actually, we gotta create a Facebook page. So every app needs to have a page. So let's just go there and let's click create page. So again, this can be named whatever you want. My recommendation is to click here, choose. Wait, hold on, that's not right. This is the one. Yeah, there we go. Right on product and click app page. So app page is just a page that Facebook gives for a particular app, right? And you just call it whatever. I'll call mine Chatbots. Okay. Cool. Right? That's right. Cool. So at this point, you should have an app created in one tab, and you should have a page created in another, right? Okay. So let's see what's going to happen. Yeah, so we have an app there. Option. If you're not on the screen, click add product and you should be brought to the screen. And then click setup. Okay, messenger, setup. Alright, cool. Okay, so now you're going to have to select the page that you just selected just now. Okay, it's going to ask you, okay, log in, test it. Basically, the Facebook app that you just created is asking for permission to manage the page that you just created just now as well. Okay, so now you got this huge long string, right? So those of you who were a little bit confused, once you clicked on Messenger setup, you scroll down and you want to token generation. Okay, and you clicked here and selected the page that you just created. so you logged into Facebook, and then after that, now you've got this huge long string. Okay, so now we're going to go back to the app that we just remixed just now. Oops, that's not it. This is it. Okay, so you're going to see, let's zoom in over here, you're going to see a little dot and a little key next to it. Alright, so glitch. So when you're writing apps online, sometimes you have things that you want to keep secret from everyone. So English.com, this is where you keep the secret stuff. So that long string is now, that long string, think of it as a password that allows anyone to change your page. Okay, so you want to make sure that you keep it secret. And you want to go to that .n file and paste it under page access token. Alright, everyone see? Page access token. So paste that long string there. Okay, cool. Okay, we got a little bit more setup to go, and then we should be ready to go. Alright? The next thing we're gonna want to do is we're gonna click setup webhooks here. So webhooks are basically little agreements between code. So let's say code from my stuff. So code in glitch, right? That's my code that I've written. Wants to talk to code from Facebook Messenger. So a webhook is a way for the code to talk to another piece of code. So we're gonna set up a webhook. Okay. Okay. And here's where that name of your app becomes really important. So you don't want to go back to. Sorry. You don't want to go back to here. Okay, get this link here, copy it, okay, copy the link, and then paste it, not in your page, but under the callback URL, paste it there, okay, I gotta add on a little bit more to it, gotta add slash webhook, okay. Too quick? Okay. So going back to what we thought just now, right? So I said, so let's go back from here. Okay, I'm gonna read it one more time. So after you've got that token and you paste it in glitch.com. Yes, on the same page. So we took this token, we copied it, and then we went to your project just now, and then we went to the .n file, and then we pasted it in the page access token. Right? Now we're going to go back to the app. Okay, we're going to scroll down a little bit more. You have the section here for webhooks. Okay, you want to click setup webhooks. You want to copy this URL here, which is the URL of your app. So click copy there. Okay, and then paste it. Okay, and if you did everything correctly, you did all currently at a phase where they have webhooks, they have messages, and they have information. Yes. Should be like set up by once. You will have a URL, and then I think
Okay. Not there.